Welcome to the animal-free version of every lasagna I ate growing up. I hope you enjoy this recipe. Keep in mind this is a double batch, so if you are only wanting to make one 9x13, you'll want to cut this in half. So here I'm rinsing the lentils that I'm using for the portion of the meat in the lasagna. You can use water, but I like the thick veggie broth. Makes it taste a little bit more full. So here I'm going to chop up some mushrooms and saute them. This is not an option that you need to use, but this is what I put in the ricotta. If you are not a fan of mushrooms, you can just use spinach. You don't have to add anything at all, but I think this bulks it up a little bit. We'll also be adding in a clove or two of garlic here. Now you can add in whatever greens you have on hand. I happen to have this 50-50 blend. I usually use spinach, but you can use kale or whatever you like and have on hand. I'm adding in a little chopped spinach that's frozen here to the mix because I had it on hand. So now I'll be making the tofu ricotta. I did use one of the sectioned tofu blocks, but if you have just two normal blocks, that will work just fine as well. Adding in a little soy milk or whatever plant-based milk you want to use. The seasonings I'll be using is this roasted garlic and herb from McCormick. I'll be using some onion powder, garlic powder, some garlic salt seasoning, some regular salt if you need it, as well as some nutritional yeast. So you just want to blend that up until it's well combined. And then here I am using tongs to put in the sauteed vegetables so that I don't get any of the mushroom water in there, and then we'll blend this up after. And there you have it. I'm checking the consistency. It looks good to me, so I'll set this aside and start with the rest. So here I'm using some Boca crumbles. I use one bag of this, and then you'll see later on that I'm going to add in some lentils. I did add in a splash or two of vegetable broth to keep the moisture up and make sure that it didn't stick to the bottom of the pan for this. If you are making this for some omnivores, you may just want to stick to the Boca crumbles, but I found that this mixture worked out just as fine. So now I'm adding in spaghetti sauce or some pasta sauce or whatever your choice, most of one jar there. And now I'm assembling. So I'm going to put in some sauce on the bottom so that the noodles don't stick to the bottom. And we'll start layering everything up. I did use just the amount of pasta noodles that I needed, but if you wanted to use a whole box and you had some leftover noodles, that's fine too. Sometimes I have leftover ricotta and you can just use that as another dish some other time. So here I'm going to skip forward to my last layer here, and I'm putting the tofu on top. I apologize for the chipmunks, I'm still getting this editing thing down. So once I have this all spread out, I will put on the meat mixture. As you can see, I'm finishing out everything just as is, so the recipe is true to the measurements, and you won't have any left over there. So I'm just putting a little bit of extra sauce on top there to sauce it up a little bit. I did only use 2 jars of sauce, but it depends on how saucy you want it. If you wanted to use more, that's completely fine too. So now I'm just using the back of my spatula to spread it all around and putting some cashew parmesan on top. That's homemade, and then I'm also using the store-bought brand from Drive Market that I have on hand. And then I'm just going to top it off here with whatever mozzarella shreds you have on hand, or whatever is your favorite. And there you have it. Now I'm going to cover one up and put it in the freezer for another time. And then I'll put the other one right in the oven. And this is what it looks like when it's all done baking.